This is Rob Bro with Carson Robinson from the Rob Bro Show on 1340 The Fan here with new Red Raider, Seth Collins. Just real quick, first of all, transferring in. Thoughts so far? Lubbock, pretty nice atmosphere compared to Oregon, right?
Great atmosphere, you know. Family environment, you know. It's a blessing to be here, man. In a locker room full of brothers, you know what I'm saying? It's one team, one unit, one band, one sound. So, you know, that's the drum line, if y'all don't know. So.
The tubas are the heartbeat of the band.
Yeah, you know. So, man, it's just been a blessing. The coaches, you know, giving me the plays, working me through it, you know, being able to come here, fine-tune my craft every day in a weight room, in a conditioning environment where everybody's excited, hungry to work. You know, it's just – that's a blessing, especially to be a football player. You want to play at a top level. You got to be around top people. So,
before we get into Rob, he's going to ask you some rapid-fire questions, but I just want to add on to that. Coming into a place like this, do they have anything like this at Oregon State? I mean, they had an indoor.
Yeah, we have an indoor. Yeah, I mean – Oregon State will put some people out, you know, right. Brandon Cooks, Marcus Wheaton, yeah. Browner, or Chad Johnson. So a number of dudes came out. It's D1 Pac-12, but, you know, the atmosphere, it's the atmosphere here. It's electrifying. It's football, so you feel it, you know what I mean?
Yeah. Hard-hitting football questions. Yep. Obviously, first year here in Lubbock. We've already gone over that. What are your expectations coming in? Although you did come in the spring.
Right.
You had a chance to learn the offense and grow into that. What are your expectations for this season?
You know, to just focus on the minors, focus on opportunity, you know, because when opportunity comes, you got to capitalize, you know. And you can't capitalize on opportunity, obviously, if you don't know the plays and you don't know your assignment. So all of that ties in, you know. It's really just about fine-tuning my craft, getting right with what I need, you know what I mean, and just playing up to the standards that's expected here, you know. So that's really what it's all about.
What's it like transferring from position – at Oregon State, you go from quarterback to receiver, and now you're going from receiver at one school to another. Is there a big language gap as far as the play calling and the schemes, or is it pretty easy to pick up once you have kind of the first scheme in your head?
Yeah, I mean, when you play quarterback and you play that, you know, I mean, Division I level, you know, there's things expected of you defensively, you know, knowing your receivers, what routes they run. If it's press, they got to run this. If it's, you know what I mean, they bail, whatever. So, you know, going from quarterback to receiver really just helped with the overall logistics of offense and how, you know what I mean, it's a universal rule to it, no matter if you run a wishbone or spread or whatever, you know what I mean, pro set. So it's just really, it's eye-opening to switch from quarterback to receiver, because now you can look at it from a receiver's perspective and see what maybe I did wrong at quarterback, and then, you know, it's just,
yeah. All right, so what's the special package with you at quarterback called? Got the Wild Raider or the Wildcat?
Practice starts tomorrow, man.
I'm just trying to get a scoop here.
We'll find out when practice starts. Man, I don't even know. You know, I'm just we're learning the playbook. You know what I mean? So
there you go. So coming into a guy like Cliff and his offense, Everybody says he's a genius, a guru at this. Yeah. Coming in, learning from a guy like that, you only get 1 year of it. Mm-hmm. But how much can learning from a guy like him set you up for next year when you're getting the NFL?
Well, you know, I do have 2 years, so.
Yeah, true, you do.
Yeah, I have 2 years.
I'm thinking you're just here 1 year, though.
Right, hey, possibilities, you know what I'm saying?
I'm trying to help you out.
Yeah. No, man, it's incredible, you know, to sit down with somebody. You know, his resume speaks for itself. You go in his office and you see all the people he's coached in the league and everybody, you know what I mean, on the main stage doing the thing that he's coached. So you can't, you know what I mean, you got to listen to that. So, you know what I mean, he knows what he's talking about and the numbers he's throwing for every game and everything like that, you know what I mean, just –
Does that fire you up as a wide receiver coming in?
It fires me up. You know what I mean? It's hard to do interviews sometimes.
I can tell.
I'll be excited. You know what I mean? Yeah, man. It's a great experience to learn from.
All right. Depth chart has you slotted in, following Kiki QT, following Jonathan Giles, following Jakeem Grant. That position, do you expect that kind of success? Is it a given here with your confidence level? Is that what you go into the season looking for?
You know, success will be the outcome of the hard work that I put in that nobody watched. So. You know, that's going to come, you know, if God willing, you know what I mean, that's what he wants me, that's what he has for me, that's what's going to happen. But, you know, I'm confident in myself and the spirit that dwells in me, my Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. So, you know, it's going to be what it's going to be, you know, so.
What about some other receivers in the room that have stood out so far, maybe some of the freshmen or some of the guys that have been here?
You know, yeah, the freshmen, you know, you got Keyshawn, he coming in fast, one of the fastest dudes, you know, in Texas. There's a bunch of guys, you know, TJ, man, has been a great person to learn the offense from. And Daquan, you know, they both come in, they work hard. Quan come in here every Saturday, he working on his routes and stuff. So to be around guys like that, you know, you can't help but learn, you know what I'm saying? Because if you're not learning, you shouldn't be here, you know.
And Final question.
Yes, sir.
What does Texas Tech, what do you guys as a team have to do this year to win a Big 12 title and put yourselves in position to play for something in the postseason?
Right, it's those little details in the game that seem not to matter, but they do. It's a game of inches, game of yards. So it's playing the whole game, fourth quarters, as you guys know. It's a long game. It'll be 15 minutes each quarter. So it's really about doing the little details right, you know what I'm saying? Protecting the football, you know what I mean? With defense, you know what I mean? Causing turnovers, three and outs, you know what I'm saying? Putting points on the board. So, you know, we just got to capitalize. That's what it's all about, you know.